Welcome to DD Garden TV. In this video, we will look at what measures we can take against the Tuta Absoluta, or tomato moth as it is known, which does not die easily even with chemical drugs. However, for this pest, which is very difficult to stop, it is not possible to say that I used this was effective. If it were that easy, scientists around the world have been researching thousands of proposed solutions for years, but they still continue to spread and wreak havoc. At this rate, perhaps the end of humanity will come because of this insect. For this reason, it is necessary to put aside the fantasies and put multiple applications into operation. Because Tuta Absoluta, which attacked tomatoes and showed destructive effects when it first appeared, then began to attack vegetables such as potatoes and eggplants, but now began to increase the variety of plants it attacked and continues its alarming climb. Tuta has recently begun to cause great damage to flowers and alfalfa varieties. There's no joke, there's no such thing as a magic product. In the fight against this pest, we can apply a few different methods. First, let's look at cultural methods. Garlic, mint and thyme, planted near tomatoes, repel the general range of moths and butterflies. In this way, we can have the chance to prevent the vegetables in our garden from being hosts. On the borders of our garden, planting aromatic herbs, we can confuse them. Tuta is able to very successfully overwinter in some weeds. Scientific research shows that among the plants that spend the winter most successfully are Solanum dulcamara, Burdock, and black nightshade. Not housing these herbs around your garden can yield good results. There are also herbs that will attract the natural enemies of Tuta Absoluta. Among them is Bifora radians. In particular, Macrolophus secretes a chemical that attracts caliginosus. If you can find this herb, try to grow it in your garden. One of the best precautions you can take against Tuta Absoluta is to protect tomatoes like tulle. If you are engaged in greenhouse cultivation, be sure to draw tulle to the greenhouse entrances. All the research we have done on Tuta Absoluta has led us to the effective ingredients pyrethrin and azadirachtin. Pyrethrin is found mainly in chrysanthemum, daisy, and tanacetum. In this type of chamomile, pyrethrin is very high, in other varieties of chamomile the rate is low. On the other hand, the recommended azadirachtin ingredients are found in low levels of neem tree leaves and in high proportions in seeds. If it is not found, neem oil can be purchased. If we come to the issue of drug productions from the products we have mentioned, 1 kilogram of chrysanthemum daisy head or tanacetum is put in 10 liters of water and after waiting for 3 days, it is filtered and used. 1 kilogram of neem tree seeds are separated from their white shells, broken and soaked in 2 liters of water. It is enough even to wait 1 day. Neem tree leaves should be used before flowering. This extract is also effective against leaf-eating caterpillars, larvae, and grasshoppers. It is an extract made by putting 1 kg of fresh neem tree leaves in 5 liters of water. The leaves are collected, crumbled, and pressed into the water from the night. The next day, the extract is filtered and used. This extract may not contain very dense azadirachtin, but rather is ideal for small fields or gardens. It is possible to make medicines with different applications from neem tree seeds. If we leave its details to another video, then the proportions of azadirachtin in seeds differ. About 2 to 9 milligrams are contained in 1 gram of neem tree seeds, averaging 5 milligrams. If we calculate that for effective spring breaker we need about 3 grams, then we need 600 grams of dry neem tree seeds. If you can dry these seeds and pulverize them, you leave them for 3 days in 2 liters of boiled water, strain them and mix them in 200 liters of water and use them. I would like to draw your attention to the fact that pyrethrin and azadirachtin are broken down by the UV rays of the sun. Effective spraying is much more effective if it can be done on a day or night without sun. You can also make an enzyme from neem tree seed. It is made by breaking 1 kilogram of neem tree seeds and soaking for 3 months in 1 liter of molasses and 3 liters of water. If it's done now, you may have a chance to use it next year. Enzyme making details can also be found in the canal. We can see that predators, which are usually hunters of whiteflies, attack Tuta absoluta during periods when they cannot find whiteflies. All of the predators used for the whitefly in biological control can also be used for Tuta absoluta. While egg parasitoids, larval parasitoids and pupal parasitots can be different, there are predators that eat Tuta in all their stages. Macrolophus and Nasidiocarus tenuus are one of them. We know that these predators are found in nature, but if you also do not have a natural environment and grow tomatoes in large areas, you can buy these predators. Let's come to the subject of entrapment. According to research, the period of the highest number of adult flights is July. In this month, it is absolutely necessary to focus on trapping applications. There are pheromone traps for Tuta absoluta, but the most effective trap is the light traps, which will be used at night when adults are very active. You can install a simple setup, you can also buy it if you want. It is useful to turn on a light in the garden and put a container under which you mix water and detergent. If you can put these traps every 20 square meters, they will be of great use in mass destruction. See you in another videos. We wish everyone beautiful gardens.